If you are watching this message, it is unfortunately clear that you have not been able to secure passage off of Earth. The apocalypse is a scary time, but we come with some exciting news.
That's right, Alexa. We would all love to continue living on our once beautiful home planet of Earth, but unfortunately, due to the global climate catastrophe and the unstoppable meteor that is currently hurtling towards Earth, that dream is impossible.
With little time until the meteor makes impact, we know you don't have many options. Fortunately for you, Mr. Bezos would like to help.
At this time, there are currently 2 vacant seats remaining on Mr. Bezos' spaceship, the Prime Deliverer.
Instead of selling these last 2 seats on the final ship to depart Earth, Mr. Bezos wants to give them to you.
Thanks to the generosity of this great man, 2 of you will win passage off of this forsaken planet and get to live another day among the world's elite.
In order to be eligible to win these seats, Mr. Bezos would like you to submit a video stating why you deserve to leave Earth and why you should be the one to help him preserve the human race in his name.
But you must hurry. This offer expires in exactly 1 hour. Once this timer reaches 0, you will have no other option but to accept your imminent death.
Should you be lucky enough to win these tickets, Mr. Bezos' team will come collect you and transport you to the launch site.
In order to ensure the integrity of this competition and the safety of the coming launch, the entire Earth will lose all power once this timer reaches 0.
On behalf of Mr. Bezos, we wish you the best of luck.
Your time begins now.
You have 1 hour.
What?
I just want to live!
Are they going to throw it.
Throw it. Get away! Go!
We gotta go!
Get away!
Get away!
Yes!
Get
away from me!
That could work. We got someone.
Hi, I'm Keith.
Tyler.
And you?
I'm Susan.
Well, Tyler, Susan, this is my wife, Becca.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
End of the world, huh? Crazy stuff.
Yep.
Reminds me of my wedding day.
You're right about that one.
Tyler.
Except this one's better. There's not a mother-in-law in sight!
Sorry about that. My husband likes to joke around.
Oh, that's all right. Mine does too.
Guilty.
So, are you guys nervous?
For what?
The space thing.
Oh, right! Only 2 seats left. Wow, yeah.
Yeah, it's nuts.
Yeah.
Can't believe the world's ending. Mm-hmm. I mean, we're like nervous, but I think we're confident about it.
Yeah.
You guys think you're gonna get the last seats?
Positive.
Yeah, pretty sure we got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. What makes you say that?
Well, I don't know. We're a cute couple.
Yeah.
We smell pretty good. We have decent hygiene.
We have decent hygiene. Well, I think what my husband is trying to say is that we're confident we're gonna be picked because we're not ugly. Okay, I understood that. But we're a cute couple.
Yikes.
Excuse me?
Well, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but you're not exactly, you know.
It's not that y'all are ugly.
No, no.
You guys are, bland.
Yeah, bland.
Okay, rude. And you're one to speak with your giant-ass stomach.
Whoa, now that was really uncalled for.
Take that back.
You just called us bland.
So what?
We're not bland. Whatever, Susan. What kind of name is that anyway?
Yeah, for real. Susan sounds like a bitch.
Yeah, a bitch that's not gonna get on that spaceship rocket thingy.
Oh, yeah, up top. Oh.
And for your information, I am not fat. I am simply pregnant.
Mm-hmm. Wait a second. Did they say that there were only 2 seats available on the ship? Or did they say that it was only 2 spots available on the ship?
Oh, did they now?
What the hell are you getting at?
Oh, well, I'm just saying that if it's only two spots, well then, you both can't go.
Honey?
Wow. This is, like, crazy.
Yeah, I know, like, wow.
What should we, like, do?
What do you mean?
Well, you know, I have a pretty good chance of being picked because, like, my uncle is, like, friends with someone who's friends with Jeff Bezos' friend. But, yeah, I think maybe we should split up.
What the fuck? What do you mean, split up?
What? I think we should find different partners.
You have 30 minutes.
No! Hey, you good?
Yeah. Yeah? Okay. No. It's the world. You know this shit?
Yeah. So, why do you want to go on the ship?
I like Aunt Liz Long.
Yeah.
Well, what about you?
I want to go to Jeff Bezos!
Oh my god, thank god.
Shit. Do not even stress.
Don't stress? The world is ending!
Yeah, but I don't know if you know this, my dad is one of the biggest government officials in the United States. I haven't seen him for like years, but I know he can help me get on the ship.
Is he even going to see your video?
He has to. And I think I know exactly what to say to get his attention.
I find it a little concerning, all right, that you have to find the right words to get your dad's attention in a doomsday scenario.
Okay, but I said, he works in the government.
Great. Fantastic. I'm glad you have a plan.
Hi. My name is Jake Lopez.
And I'm Jervon Monroe, and this is our attempt at getting into whatever spaceship that you're doing.
Honestly, we're still trying to wrap our heads around this whole crazy-ass end-of-the-world situation. So.
Yeah, this is probably the most stressful interview I've ever had in my life.
I mean, we know the chances of us getting a spot on the ship is basically zero, but we have to try, right?
Yeah, which is why you should take Jake, because he'd be a very great resource for whatever space job that you might have.
No, you have to take Jerv. I mean, I've known him my entire life. He has gone out of his way hundreds of times to pull me out of whatever hole I've dug for myself.
No. Look, this dude has spent many Thanksgivings helping the poor and homeless and giving anything in his house to help them. So take this generous man and...
Generous? Jervon took out a second mortgage on his childhood home to help me pay for my mom's medical bills. You're the most generous person I know. Take him.
So, no matter what, one of us is gonna get fucked over.
No, don't be stupid, Tyler. We've been friends for years. We're not gonna fuck up each other's chances of getting on that ship.
Well, regardless, there's only two seats left, so... one of us is getting left behind. Bullshit, you ain't leave my ass nowhere
behind. Hey, no one said it was you. That's what we're figuring out right now. I mean, it could be you. I don't know.
All right. How are we going to do this?
Leave my ass here and see what happens. Leave my ass.
You'll die. Look, we got to do this now. I say we just film our own individual takes for why we should get to go on the ship. No lies, no fucking each other up. I mean, we love each other. And if one of us gets to go on that ship, the least we can do is be happy for them. Deal?
Well, I think I should be the one to go.
Dude, hell no. Just because you lived a sorry-ass little life doesn't mean I want to die.
No, Steven. I watched you eat a bag of frozen peas and carrots for dinner the other night that you didn't even heat up. That's gotta be rock bottom, dude.
They get too hot in the microwave.
Are you guys ready to make your video now?
Okay, hey, dude, just
give
us a minute.
Shut the fuck up, Michael! Right?
Shit.
Looks like both of you can't go if you're gonna bring that baby of yours with you.
Well, that doesn't mean that the two of you are gonna go.
Yeah.
Sure, but as long as you guys don't get it, I don't really care.
Yeah. Wait, you don't care?
No, not really.
What the hell, Tyler? You don't care about living?
Well, sure I do, but as long as I care more about them not living. It's purely principle, honey.
Damn. Okay. Fine. Maybe I'll do it by myself then and get a spot with someone who actually cares about living. And they're going to be cool and fun, and they're going to give me back massages and drink fruity drinks with me and not be embarrassed about it.
Fine. Go do that then.
Good. I will.
Good. I will.
Oh. Looks like someone needs marriage counseling.
Oh, I'm glad we're not like that.
You both still know you can't both go, right?
This blows.
Yep.
You know, dying doesn't sound too bad anymore.
This is the end! Well, you guys want to go bowling?
Sure.
Yeah, I mean, that sounds like fun.
Cool.
Barry.
Yep.
Awesome.
You can't do this to me! You know I'll be left behind if we split up! You can't do this to me! We've been best friends our whole lives!
Oh my God, I feel bad. I'm sorry. But I still think we should grow in separate directions.
You can't leave me! If you leave me, I'll tell them what you did!
No!
Yes, I'll have to! If you leave me, I'll tell them what you did last summer!
No, no! You can't! They'll never take me if they knew! Please don't tell them!
Okay,
cool. What do we do?
I have a lot of supplies that they might need, so we can bring those and try to get on that way. Yeah.
That's good. Okay. I worked at a nursing home once and I stole all the blankets last week.
Amazing.
So.
Perfect. Okay. Alright, so let's work together.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Okay. Great. Let's go.
Hello, Mr. Bezos. My name is Stephen Foster. If you're watching this, I just want you to know that I am the biggest supporter of you and your company. While I don't have Amazon Prime, I'd love to be the next same-day shipment to get off this rock. I'm a hard worker. I can cook. I can...
Dude, peas and carrots.
Go edit that out.
This is live?
I'm a hard worker. I can learn to cook. I'm willing to learn on the job. And I have a brilliant 12-step program to bring your space dollars skyrocketing for years to come.
Oh yeah, how you doing there, bro? How you doing there? How you doing there?
Huh? I guess Jeff will have to figure that out himself. But don't let such a crucial investor get blown up into space. Pick me. Let's both save on our taxes.
Pick me! Let's both save on our taxes! Oh, I'm a dumbass! Can't save on your goddamn gas, you stupid ass motherfucker.
You have 15 minutes.
Well, you're my best friend. It's our plan.
Best friend?
Yeah, I've known you for like years.
Yeah, and you've treated me like shit the whole time.
What are you talking about?
Shauna, Miss Kenderson's class. You knew I liked her, and you told her I flossed my teeth with my toenails.
That was third grade.
You remember Josh, freshman year? You sent a 6 to approach a 10 on your behalf, and when he turned you down, what did you say? Sorry, my friend just wanted to harvest your kidneys.
Okay, I don't know if any of those stories are true, but either way, both of us have great imaginations.
No, you've been gossiping and causing drama since first grade, and I've paid every price for it.
That's silly. Okay, if I ever gossiped, I was gossiping with you.
Mm-mm. No, I can't trust you. I can't trust you. And how am I supposed to put my life in your hands? Huh? How about in your dad's hands?
Do you have any other choice? Look, if I haven't proved myself to you before, let me prove it to you now.
Swear?
Swear. Damn.
Keep trying.
I I was the one that sold your dad's baseball card for $5 for weed.
You did what? Jerv, he left me those when he died. What are you?
I'm sorry. I really wanted to get high.
Fuck you! High? Remember when your mom took your license in high school because she smelled weed in the attic? That was me, bitch!
I fucking told you never to touch my weed. I knew you fucking don't. That's why I put fucking Gorilla Glue in your fucking shampoo when we went to Camp Walla Walla.
That took weeks to get out of my hair, Jerv! You know... Fine. Guess what?
What?
I fucked your sister at prom. And it was good.
Fuck you! No, leave this piece of shit here. Take me. I'm a better man anyway.
No, fuck him. I have Amazon stock. He invested in vintage Care Bears like an asshole.
Oh, whoop dee doo, and I'm fucking black, no one fucking cares.
No, no, please. Use your words.
It's my weed.
How could you do that to my weed?
Look at them, fighting over such silly nonsense.
As if they stand a chance.
As if any of them stand a chance.
No, they haven't even read Boswell.
Chapter 16, line 319.
Oh man, that one takes me back.
Oh, what a privilege it is.
Yes, a privilege.
To see the most beautiful sight mankind will ever see.
Those fools, they think it's called, I don't even remember.
It's been so long since
I referred to it as even.
A meteor shower.
No, it's not a meteor at all.
No, meteors are a government ploy to discourage deep space exploration.
Absolutely. Meteors? No, disgusting. Disgusting. They are the most beautiful spaceships coming to us from the planet Zegmar.
Say it again.
Zegmar.
Oh, one more time.
Zegmar.
If that doesn't give you chills, nothing will. Ugh, one more time, please.
Zegmar!
I can't wait for them to come and take us to our home among the stars.
Where we belong.
Where real truthers belong.
Yes. Hey, Bezos, more like Bozos, am I right?
The Zegmar ships are gonna blow the Prime Deliverer right out of the water.
Technically it'd be more like right out of the deep space. Universe,
take me home to the place I belong. Planet Zegmar, home of the flat-dwarf race, which is obviously superior to the human race.
Of course.
UFOs, take me home.
One more time.
UFOs.
You have 10 minutes.
Hey, Jeff. Remember me? Tyler, I won the food eating contest last year for eating 300 cheeseburgers. And must I say I won me 500,000s of dollars. How? But, you know, to help fund that Black Friday for the shitty-ass space...
No, that's not even close to how much that
Dude,
costs. No.
You couldn't even pay me that for Burger King. I have more Buckaroos than the both of you for my space snacks, and you best to believe I'm gonna take me some chips with me. So, Jeff, what do you want to order? I'm on my way to Burger King right now.
You son of a bitch.
Hey, stop. You know, Jeff, you know when you started that Amazon thing in your garage? I started a Congo line in mine around the pong table. You ever been fucked up in space, Jeff? I haven't. So come on, pick me! Take a brother! What would Jesus do?
Yeah, Jesus would say money's the root of all evil. But I don't believe that. Hi, Mr. Bezos. I'm Jack Shanahan. I'm a good sport, I like pulling my weight, and I would love to be your next and last cadet on your current space flight. My life has been tragic, to say the least. I was raised by a pack of wolves in Indiana after being abandoned on the side of the road by the couple that stole me from the hospital. I had to watch my den mother get eaten by a sleuth of bears when I was just 2 years old.
Jack? A sleuth of bears?
Yeah, that's what it's called.
You look like a damn bear, grizzly.
3 months ago, I decided to explore my human roots, which has led me to now. So please, give me a second chance at the game of life.
Dude, you grew up in a white, well-off Catholic family in North Carolina.
Okay, yeah. Dude, I've had my struggles, okay?
Struggles? You couldn't find out the munch on that big-ass silver spoon he had.
Yeah, I don't want to hear shit from you, Cheeseburger Man. Tell me. No, tell the big man. Whatever happened to your 500,000 buckaroos?
Well, what can I say, Jeff? McRibs are a limited time only.
Yeah, exactly.
See, Jeff, if I had $500,000 to blow away, I wouldn't. I'd invest and start a company just like you.
Just like the NFT that nobody can right-click on?
The data will show that it still belongs to me. Travis Scott did it.
Whoa. Please do not use Travis Scott as a role model.
You're my role model, Jeff.
Kiss ass. You know, I hope both of you get blown the fuck up.
Tyler here shat the bed until he was 15.
I told you that out of confidence.
And he still does. Every other Thursday.
And how would you know?
Yeah, actually, how would you know that?
Well...
Alright, so it's become clear that Steven here is a stalker and is clearly unfit to be kept in a little space box with the remainder of humanity.
Yeah, and from my findings, Jack here can't get it up.
Holy shit.
Oh. You guys are fucked. Whoa!
Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Goodbye.
Welcome aboard the Prime Deliverer. Congratulations on surviving the apocalypse. Mr. Bezos is looking forward to spending the rest of eternity.
Made it. You know, I had a dream that made me believe that there were reptilioids living among us. It was quite a weird dream. They weren't like normal reptilioids. They were like weird, tentacly, scaly, long tongues, you know, abnormally large sort of appendages. And within those reptilioids, the leader was Mr. Bezos himself. I went through this dream, and all of a sudden I was falling. I don't even understand why. Did I fall out of a ship? Did I jump into the air and just fly? Hell happened. Ooh. And then I was running. I was running through this deserted world, running and running and running, Mr. Bezos influencing me all the while. And I just sat there and I was losing my mind. And then, you won't get me! Get my reptilioids! Mama? I made it, Mama. Are you proud of me yet? Mother? I made it, Mother.
Go on.
I made it, Mother. I made it to fruition.
But what comes next? Who knows? I just know those reptilians will never get me now.
As if any of them stand a chance.
Climb.
Zegmar ships are gonna blow that climb through.
Oh, one more time.
Wait for us to go to our. Oh, God. For us to come to that. I can't wait for them to come and take us to our planet among the stars.
Where we belong.
Very chlorinated in there.
While I'm not exactly a Amazon Prime member. What's up?
What up? Alright. That was your one. Alright. But yeah, let me take it again.
Oh wow.